Hello friends, today we are going to talk of the oral drugs that are used for egg formation. So many patients come to us and they tell us about the medicines that they have taken, and we need to give some information to them about the medicines that need to be taken for egg formation. So most of the times we tell our patients that if you have regular periods and you are trying to get pregnant, don't just start drugs to form the egg, because a regular period suggests that the egg would have been formed. So every lady does not need ovulation induction drugs. Who needs ovulation induction drug is a lady who does not regular periods. So what are the most common drugs that are used is, previously clomiphene citrate or Clomid, which was known by the name Clomid, was the drug which was used very often for ovulation induction. So ovulation induction means a lady who does not have regular periods, we need to give her medicine to form an egg. So clomiphene citrate was a very popular drug. It came in the 1950s and it was used to form the egg. Sometimes it forms more eggs than is needed. That is why these patients need monitoring. And then these days, letrozole is the drug. So letrozole 2.5, 5 milligram is most often used for ovulation induction. Some patients also need injections in addition to the oral drugs, but these need to be done in hands of an expert, because if eggs formed are more, then we might have to convert this patient to IVF. Or sometimes we might have to cancel the cycles. Sometimes the patient has a risk of developing multiple pregnancies, and sometimes they have a risk of developing ovarian hyperstimulation. So giving oral drugs and gonadotrophins or injections to form eggs in combination needs to be done in the hands of an expert. So clomiphene citrate, it needs to be taken from day 3 to day 5, like for 5 days. And then a scan needs to be done to check the number of follicles that are growing. And letrozole also needs to be taken from day 2, day 3, for 5 days. And then we do a scan to find out. So letrozole is the most commonly used drug. It is the first line drug. Evidence tells us that it is the first line drug. Why it is better than clomiphene citrate is, letrozole leads to formation of 1 or 2 eggs. It is more commonly responsible for forming 1 or 2 eggs. Then letrozole does not give rise to a thin endometrium, which was a problem with clomiphene. Clomiphene patients used to come and tell us that the uterus lining was very thin, whereas in letrozole, this problem does not occur. It's the first line drug. It gives higher chances of pregnancy, and it is used as a first line drug in most of the patients these days. Most of the patients don't have many symptoms. Usually patients who take letrozole don't have many side effects, little bit of nausea and giddiness, which also gets compensated if the patient takes the drug in the bedtime. So they eat the drug and then they go off to sleep. And usually at 5 milligram, ovulation occurs. Sometimes we might have to use some injections in combination sequentially with the oral drug to form the egg. So the oral induction drugs are used for IUIs, or they need to be taken for patients who have irregular cycles where the egg is not feed formed. Most of the times these drugs don't have many side effects. They are very safe. However, there is a word of caution that these drugs should not be used for n number of cycles, any number of cycles. So usually we tell our patients to restrict the number of cycles to 6 and sometimes to 12. But taking too many ovulation induction drugs is not good for the health of the patient, because these drugs can lead to formation of egg. Once the egg ruptures, it leads to formation of a cyst. And some patients can have persistent formation of cysts. That is, there might be too many cysts or hemorrhages lying inside the ovary, and which might reduce the chances of success in the subsequent cycle. So patients whom we put on ovulation induction drugs, we tell them to take a break of 1 or 2 months if pregnancy does not happen, and then again start the drug, so that the ovary gets time to heal itself, the cyst to resolve, and the ovary to come back to its neutral gear. So ovulation induction drugs have problems of forming residual cysts. That is some kind of blood collection inside the ovary, which takes time to go. So finally, at the end of this video, we need to understand that ovulation induction drugs are mostly two, that is clomiphene citrate or letrozole. Letrozole is a better drug than clomiphene citrate. It has lesser side effects. It is safer. It causes mono or bifollicular response. And patients who take ovulation induction drug for IUI or for trinaturally need to undergo ovulation scans. They need to be checked how many number of eggs have been formed. And then subsequently, too many cycles are not indicated. 6 to 12 cycles is the final number. If the patient takes more than this time, It might not harm the body, but it might not lead to benefits also. So anything that has been done many number of times and it has not worked, it is unlikely that it will work in the future. So patients who've had 6 to 12 cycles of ovulation induction drugs should stop, and then they should consult their fertility consultant as to what should be the next step. And if you have any questions on ovulation induction drugs, you can put a comment in the comment section. We shall be happy to reply it. Thank you.